What is up, everybody? Welcome back to episode of Ford Era. Today you got me, Solomon, here, and
we are at Cato's Custom Upholstery / Fuller Moto,
and he's doing a building class on how to build seats, make the foam, do all that stuff. So I wanted to bring you guys along because we're going to show you how to do all this and make your own custom seat. So
the class is about to start, and I'm going to try to show you guys as much as possible.
So stay tuned. This is going to be a fun video. Hello everybody, welcome to day two of Bitchin Stichin. We're gonna go over a little seat patterning for you real quick with Solomon. Here we go. Hey everybody, I'm Solomon, and I'm here at Cato Custom Upholstery Seat Building Class, and he taught me how to make patterns, and so I'm gonna take those patterns and transfer them out to leather. Okay, so I'm gonna show you how to do that now. Me and Cato again. We're talking about putting the leather that Solomon cut out onto the foam. So we need to worry about a few things. One, to make sure that the leather is cut out correctly, which he did a great job on. And two, the placement of the leather on the foam. So the foam itself has to stretch this way and this way. So knowing that this is the top holster here, Solomon, we want it to pull left to right. Okay? So we're gonna flop that on there like that. And we're gonna glue it on. We're good now. You need to draw your design, whatever you're gonna draw on here. And then once you do that, then we're ready to stitch.
So, this middle foot, that one, you want it right there. That edge of that foot on that middle foot. And just ride that as good as you can. And, you know, if you get a little wobbly, it doesn't matter. It's gonna get stitched in. You just want that foam trimmed nice against there. So when you got a pattern on top of the other pattern, you got a nice, you know, straight edge to work off of. So when you're sewing, you're not getting all wiggly. You know, that's something very noticeable.
Okay.
When you get good, you can go that fast.
Hey, welcome back. Day three, and Solomon has made a almost seat cover.
Almost seat cover.
But now the fun part comes where we're gonna sew it all together.
And it becomes a seat cover.
So you did a great job.
Thank you.
So
you did a good job, or a great job of teaching, and Johnny really did a great job of showing me
how to sew up.
So yeah.
Johnny's an amazing stitcher.
He's just amazing all around.
He is. Great looking, good worker, great stitcher.
He named his son Ford.
Right. Oh, he is a Ford guy.
Yeah, he named his son Ford.
And he named his son Ford.
I didn't even do that. My wife wouldn't let me.
I know. But he's cooler than you.
He is way cooler.
No, I'm just kidding.
Way cooler than me. He went to Sturgis for years. I never even been to Sturgis. That already says he's cooler.
Right. And stitched up. Man, he's got some stories, but that's for a whole another day.
Can't talk about it on
PG. No. Absolutely not. Yeah. Yeah, we keep it PG for the kids. And no cussing.
Cato love the kids.
So
what's the first step?
So what I'm gonna advise you to do is go on and sew up your insert pieces, which would be this front piece that you have that you've made to roll over here, and then your back piece that you've made to roll over the back.
Okay.
Once we get that sewn up, that piece is done. We're just gonna set it aside for now once it's sewn up. And then we're gonna get to a little bit more technical stuff because of the corners and things like that. But I have faith in you because your stitch lines are extremely straight. So I'm super excited.
Thank you.
How that turned out. I know Johnny sewed a few of them, but
yeah, he did.
I couldn't,
two, I believe.
And that's the funny. It's like I can't tell which ones he sewed and which one you did. So either we're really good teachers or you're a really good natural stitcher. So
I think you're really good teachers.
Okay, good. Yeah. But your mom sewed too, right?
My mom sewed.
So we'll thank your mom for that talent.
I thank my mom for everything.
I would too.
Yes. Love her.
I'm not going to sit here and talk about your mom like that.
You don't even know her.
I know. I'll be like, you know, your mama said. Leave that for another day too.
Your mama.
Right. We got to keep it PG, remember?
Right. All right. So how do we just fold this over and I buzz one in?
That's it. Right. Remember when we talked about like the 3/8 seam allowance and stuff like that?
Uh-huh.
And that's where this little stitch right here comes in handy because we're going to take that foot over there and we're going to let that little guy guide right on that stitch, and that's going to give us a perfect 3/8 seam allowance. So you ready to do it?
I'm ready.
You want me to hold the camera while you do it?
Why not?
Get a Solomon eye view here. Solomon, rookie here, but what happened is you could probably put your hand through there. But we're gonna go back and fix that. All right,
okay.
I'm just gonna show you how to fix it. So don't be disappointed that it's there.
Oh, right. Wow. No, that's not even the worst part.
I know. And we'll fix that, I'm gonna show you. We're gonna cut it up, and we're gonna do it again.
All right. See, you can mess up, and we'll show you how to fix it, or Cato sure will.
So, Solomon.
I'm not used to ice. That's a rough
job. Gonna help you.
Without ice.
There's nothing wrong with this. Because making mistakes is the best way to learn, right?
Absolutely.
So I don't find making mistakes frustrating, especially what we do, because we all make mistakes.
Oh, here's some highways.
I call them happen little learning advice tips.
I like it.
All right.
Just carefully cut them all, get a nice sharp razor blade.
That's it, nice sharp razor blade. And we're gonna cut this off. Now, I'm gonna sit at the machine and you can watch me do it so you know better for the next one.
Okay, I definitely have plenty more to do. So.
Yeah. All right. But it's good, I like your enthusiasm and just get in there attitude, all right?
I mean, that's the only way you're going to learn.
Absolutely.
I don't mind messing up. At the end of the day, this is what this is, a practice piece just for this purpose.
Right. And have you ever run a sewing machine before?
No.
Yesterday, right? Was the first day.
Today.
Or today.
Yeah. This there morning.
You go. So. Now let's check how we did. There we go.
Hey.
And now we're on, and we're on the end. We're on the end, and we have our center stitch lined up. Are you ready?
Oh, we're ready.
Are you ready?
You ready?
I'm ready. Are you ready?
So, Solomon, you did a few practice pieces. Which should be over here on this corner. Because it does take some time to perfect this, right? So before you mess up your piece, I said, hey, Solomon, let's do a little practice piece.
I still mess up my piece, though.
Right. So now you have a yarmulke.
Yeah.
And through God's will, you could sew this up good, right?
Let's give it a whirl, baby.
All right, let's do this.
The rhythm of the night. Oh yeah.
Not too shabby.
No. Not at all. How do you feel about this, man?
So Solomon's Custom Upholstery. You know, I'm just kidding. I like it. I would definitely be scared to put a top stitch on it. But I'm very happy with how it looks. I know once we cut this piece out, it'll not do that little thing, right?
That's right.
Yeah.
Exactly right.
All right, well, we're gonna try the second one and we're gonna do it in faster mode, so enjoy the time lapse.
Yeah, it looks pretty damn good, Sol.
Well, you know.
I mean, I'd almost bring you into the shop for not only social media stuff, but I may even let you stitch up my blind grandmother's seat.
Well, I don't know why she'd be driving, but whatever.
It doesn't matter.
Okay.
She just fills with the stick and she drives.
There
it's
you
that
go.
New improved thing. It's just out there like this. And as it hits something, it beeps.
Hey, that sounds like fun.
But she drives a Tesla, so it's okay. Self-driving. Oh. She says car. Take me to the grocery store.
It does.
And what does it do? It takes her to my house instead.
Did she get her groceries though?
That's all that matters.
That's what matters.
Yeah, gotta keep Bobby and my grandmother happy, right? So, all right, check this out. See how you did there, Solomon. If you did like crap, it was Johnny's fault, right?
Always.
But if you did good, definitely, definitely you can blame me for that one. Oh, which, you know, we still have to trim all that.
Yep.
But if you look at it, it's looking good.
Looks pretty good.
So pretty happy with everything.
Super happy with it.
Yep. Now we should do a little trimming, and then we'll glue it on.
Nice. Woo. All right,
nice
I'm gonna
work.
Show you guys that in a second.
All right, so Solomon whipped up a awesome cover. It's all sewn up and everything, but to put the cover on, we need to make some allowances for some seams to lay in and make sure everything lines up. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take our little belt sander doodad here, and we're gonna trim out a little channel for those seams to sit in. And when we start gluing this on, I'll show you and it'll make a lot more sense. Okay? So we're gonna try to keep this as straight as we can. Wipe yourself, huh?
Got you guys nice and dirty.
Yep. Now we got it ready. Let's go put this cover on.
Do we need to? I saw some of the guys did this one. Is that not as necessary?
We're not going to do it on yours, and I'm going to show you why here in a minute.
Okay.
All right. try this at home. That's some gangster stuff. Get her tufting going.
Fancy schmancy.
It's tufting being a tufting tool.
So cringe.
Ugh.
So cheeseball.
Yeah,
that joke. Yet that's why we love you.
Don't ever tell anybody that joke. I'm gonna be made fun of here.
I might cut it out, likely won't.
Yeah, you should definitely cut that out. Sorry guys, you had to hear that.
It's crazy how it literally just transforms.
Yep, and that's all into when you made that pattern, you paid attention to all those measurements and everything else. Because then you're covered, literally. Just fits like a glove. We're not really fighting this or anything else. I'm just putting the seams where it goes. This one, and being that this is your first seat, and I'm gonna show you the difference, is that you can see how this is super consistent, right? Mm-hmm. You have a nice curve there. If you look at this one, which I can try to fix this, but it's a little choppy here, mm-hmm. and that's okay, but that's where putting that seam allowance when you're folding it over and getting all that stuff lined up is so
really
important.
Makes a difference.
Right, but as a first seat, dude, this is awesome.
I'm happy with it.
Right, yeah. There's no complaining here. All right, welcome back.
It's been a long time.
Hello, darling. It's been a long time since we stapled this seat back together. Are you ready for this?
I'm ready.
That was pretty lame.
So now we can show them why this line's been here this whole
time. That's right. This line is so important because we marked this where it has a 2-inch overhang. But what the deal is, if you don't have this line and you start to pull this, you could pull this cover down more, mm-hmm. or you could pull it not enough, and then this would end up looking like this and baggy. So if we just pull it to that line, just like that, we know exactly what we're doing, because when we made the patterns and everything else, everything should come out just fine. Now you get the gist of Solomon's seat here.
Boom.
So, a little tweaking here, a little tweaking there, but all in all, well done. You're
Thank
a pretty
you.
Darn good student.
What do you got to say to whoever's watching this video? Because we're pretty much ending it over here. So this is, you guys saw all the steps. Here is the final version. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. And what do you got to tell everybody who's going to try to attempt to do this stuff?
Come see me, learn some stuff. Teach me some stuff. Check me out at Cato's Custom Upholstery on Instagram. And hit me up on a DM if you need anything or if you have any questions. Appreciate it.
Heck yeah.
And as always, if you guys enjoyed this video, please smash that like button. It really helps us out. Drop a comment below. Let me know what you think about how this turned out and how you like this type of video, if you want me to do more videos like this. And as always, if you want to get some cool merch, head over to fortair.com. Got those hats, shirts just like this, bunch of other stuff. And we'll catch you in the next video.